Daily FOD walks for kids. What is this and how do you play? Okay, I'm going to share this with you today. Hi there, I'm Angela Brown, and this is Ask a House Cleaner. This is a show where you get to ask a house cleaning question and I get to help you find an answer. Now, today's show is brought to us by funcleaningshirts.com. And did you know that we make fun cleaning shirts for kids? And I made a special one that says, I did my FOD walk, and I made it for this show. So I'm going to have you check it out at funcleaningshirts.com, and I will leave links in the show notes as well. All right, so what is a FOD walk? FOD, F-O-D, it stands for foreign object debris. Now, we got this from the airline industry. And if you've ever stood there at the airport and you're waiting for your plane to come in and you're standing there with your nose pressed up against the window and you look down on the tarmac, what you can see is a great big T that's parked right in front of the gate that you're waiting for the plane to come in. Now, as the plane comes around the corner and it's pulling up to the gate, it's got those great big wings and the engines are spinning and you can see the spinning of the engines. And as it comes around, it plants the nose of the plane, the wheels of the plane. It matches it up to that great big T that's painted on the ground, and it pulls in as if that is the landing strip for that particular plane. Now, here's an interesting fact. When that plane comes in and the wings are out here on the side of the plane, but you've got the engines that are spinning, what happens is the spinning of the engines can pick up foreign object debris that is on the tarmac. Now, as you're looking out the window, you say, there's no debris. I don't see anything. But what happens is this. There's a belt loader that they pull up to the side of the plane. You might have seen this. They open the door of the plane and they start sending the suitcases out where someone has a cart and they take them off the belt loader and they put them in the cart. Well, that belt loader has little edges on it that snap your luggage tags off. I know, I hate that this is the case, but as the belt rotates around, sometimes they get caught inside the edges of the belt loader. So it will yank off your luggage tag, or it might yank off the zipper of your suitcase. And so as it yanks it off, it throws it onto the ground. So even the people that are out there working the plane, they don't see that it happened. It's almost like an invisible thing that happened, and it's a machine that eats your zippers. I know, you didn't know what happened to them, did you? That's what happens. It yanks off your luggage tags and it yanks off those little zippers. That is the foreign object debris. All right, so now it's on the ground. And then as the next airplane comes in, it can suck those into the engine and then it breaks it apart. All right, so what does this have to do with house cleaning? Well, what happens is this, and this is where we get the FOD walk from. One of the jobs of the ramp agents, and you'll see the ramp agents outside, they wear bright orange or yellow vests. There are reflective vests, and when they're out on the ramp before the plane comes in, sometimes it looks like they're just wandering aimlessly around the airport. They're not wandering aimlessly. What they're doing is a FOD walk. They have a bucket that says F-O-D on it for foreign object debris, and they're picking up these luggage tags and zippers and any other piece of garbage that could get caught in the engine that could break the engines of the plane. It's a safety measure. And so they do their FOD walks. It's part of their job. Okay, now here's how it has to do with house cleaning. In house cleaning, if we were to do a FOD walk, it would help us prevent us from vacuuming up Legos, for example, or other small toys, or screws, or paper clips, or small things, hairpins, things that can get caught inside the rollers of the vacuums and can break your vacuums. And so as kids, before we vacuum, we can send the kids on a FOD walk. And so in the airline industry, there's a bucket, and the bucket is usually hanging on the edge of the stairwell that goes up to the jet bridge where everybody knows where it is. And when they do their FOD walk, they pick up all these little bits of things that can get caught in the engines and they put those inside this bucket. Okay, so at your house, you can have a FOD bucket too. And it doesn't have to be a 5-gallon bucket, but it can be any kind of bucket you want. Or it can be a box, it can be a basket, it doesn't matter. But what you can do is send the kids on a FOD walk around your house and have them pick up anything that's small that could get eaten or chewed up by the vacuum. And I'm going to share with you this. It's awesome, even if you're not vacuuming, to have it as part of their daily activities. Hey guys, while I'm fixing dinner, why don't you guys do a FOD walk of the living room? That way, when you walk in and you're in your stocking feet after you've put the kids to bed, you're not stepping on nails and screws and Lego toys and small little bits of this and that that they've been playing with, or little game pieces or whatever, right? You're not going to be stepping and tripping on things. Now, how big is FOD? It's not just little tiny things that get caught in the vacuum. It's also bigger things. So let's say that you were out at the airport and you were watching, and then a flyby happened. Let's say it was, I don't know, either the plane that came in and it gushed some wind in, or it could be the wind itself. It blows sometimes like paper cups or pop cans or things like that onto the ramp. Those also get caught. So even if there's a bigger piece of debris in our homes, it's not going to be a pop can or something. I mean, I guess it could be, but it's going to be something like a sweater or a towel or an extra pillow or something that was left behind. Anything that is a foreign object debris is something that is not supposed to be there. Okay. And so if you explain to your kids, here's what FOD is, we're doing a FOD walk right now. You can actually have prizes if you want, give out prizes for who does the most FOD or who collects the most pieces or whatever. So it's a fun game that you can play, but it is a daily chore in most people's homes to do a FOD walk. Anyway, so I'm super excited to share with you this concept so that now you can start doing FOD walks inside your house. I know a lot of parents are going to appreciate this one, because not only is it a fun game, but it will tidy up your house in ways I can't even explain. All right, I hope this helps a little bit. If it does, please pass this on to a friend. If we've earned your subscription, please subscribe. And until we meet again, leave the world a cleaner place than when you found it.